Last time we were trying to deal with housing prices and trying to predict what a house is worth based on various things like how many bedrooms it has and stuff like that. And our big insight was that we can do all of this computation for all the houses at once using the dot product. We could, for example, take this X matrix that has all of the data for all the houses, multiply it by a vector C that contains all our coefficients. And then that will return back a value to us, which here I'm calling Y, but is really kind of our prediction, or in this case, the prices for all the houses. Right? So what are those variables? We have an X, which was known, matrix of data from the data frame. We had a C, which was known, that kind of defined our model. That was all the coefficients or our model parameters. And then we were using those to compute an unknown, which was Y or prices, or you could put different variables on that if you want. So we were computing this third unknown from the two knowns, and we're going to be doing a similar thing this time, but we're going to change what is unknown. We're going to say that we know X, so we know all the things about the houses, and we know Y, so we know the prices that they sold for. And from that, can we infer what C is? What coefficients kind of describe the housing market? And so what I've done here is I've read in a data frame. The same data as last time, actually. Except now you see I have prices, right? So I didn't have that. I had the rest of the stuff, but not price. And so what I'm going to really do is I'm going to kind of think of these three columns as being my X matrix, and then this price as being my Y vector. And then what I want to do is I want to figure out, well, what is the C that contains the coefficients that try to relate these things? So the formula I'd maybe try to work towards is something like this. I'm going to assume that I can multiply the number of beds by C0, the number of baths by C1, the year by C2, and then basically add C3, and that should give me the price of the house, right? So that's the general equation I'm working with. And when people are doing machine learning, right, they might start with different general equations, sometimes maybe more complicated than this one. But this is the kind of equation we'd have for a linear model, which is what we're kind of working with now in the course. Now, if this is my general equation, what I want you to think about is how every row of my data gives me a new equation, right? Because when I look up here, I saw that when I had two beds, one bath, 1985, I got 196,000. And so I could plug that in, right? I could plug in two for beds, I could plug in one for baths, and so on. And I would get this exact equation right here. Okay, well, I look at another row. I have 3, 1, 190, 1998, 26, 50, 56. And well, I plug that into this general equation that I'm trying to figure out, and I get this simpler equation down here. And so what I want you to start doing is thinking in terms of like, hey, if I have a row of data and I have a model that I'm trying to figure out, well, that gives me an equation. And so for the more rows I have, the more equations I have. The more columns I have, well, the more variables I'm trying to solve for, right? Because each column I add, I need to have another coefficient for that column. I need another C value. And so you might remember, maybe you encountered this in high school at some point, but when you have systems of equations like this, you can usually solve them when you have the same number of equations and variables. And that's exactly what I have here, right? I have these four equations and these four variables. And maybe you even remember how you might go about solving that. Maybe you might say, oh, I'm going to subtract this equation away from this equation to eliminate C0, and you kind of work your way down and figure out what one variable was at a time, right? So you could probably do that, maybe with a little bit of a refresher. Okay, so one of the great things about NumPy is it turns out that it could do all that work for us. If you give NumPy four equations and four variables, well, usually it should tell you the answer. And so how will we do that? Well, first off, I need to capture all of the data in this data frame into a NumPy array. Okay? And when we're dealing with NumPy, right, I guess there's all these different forms, right? I mean, we have our data frame, we have our equations, which I want you to start thinking of as equivalent, And we might also have our data at equivalent NumPy array. So I'm going to get into the NumPy array so I can do the solving, right? But the NumPy array, again, is maybe similar to or equivalent to all of these equations. Okay, so I have my houses, and I can pull out the underlying NumPy array. And this isn't quite right because this has the price here, so I want to get rid of that. So I should slice this immediately. I should say, well, I have to get a row slice and a column slice. I want all the rows, and I want everything except the last column. So I have that. So that's my x. And remember last time how I want to be able to have something like this? I want to be able to say something like 1 times C3. To do that, I need to have a special ones column. Last time I did that by just adding in a new series into my data frame. I'm going to do it a little bit different this time. Instead, I'm going to use numpy.ones. I promised you a while back that I would actually show you a use case for that. And I want to arrange these four ones as a column so that I can glue it onto the end of this matrix, right? So I'm going to say dot reshape, and here I say rows and columns. I want to have one column and however many rows necessary, which in this case is of course four. And then what I want to do is I want to glue that onto x. So I could say, how would I normally do this? I'd say numpy.concatenate. Concatenate, hopefully I can spell that. And then I'd have to pass in a tuple, right? I'd have to have the tensor one and tensor two, something like that. And so my tensor one is x, and my tensor two is this new column that I'm just kind of making up on the fly. And I do that, and it's complaining about the dimensions of these things. And the reason it's not happy about the dimensions is it's trying to stack x on top of this when I really want it to be to the side. So just remember, I can always pass an axis, and 0 means down, which is the default. Not what I want. I want a cross, which is 1. So I do that, and I can see, well, great, I have this a nice matrix here. And that's going to be my new x, right? So I have my new x like that, and that all looks good. Okay, so I have my x. Let me go way back to the equation we're trying to solve. We're really trying to solve this thing, right? I know my x, I know my y. How do I figure out what c is? So let's pull out c as well. I haven't done that yet. And c was just this last, or I'm sorry, I want to pull out y. Y was just the last column of this data frame. So let me do that. I'm going to say y. Well, here, I'm going to say houses dot values. I want to get all the rows, and I want to get the last column. You can actually see how nice that is, right? Like last time I was getting everything before the last column. Now I'm getting the last column to make it complete. And I'm just going to make that as a slice, right? So I'm going to say last column until the end, just so it's vertical like that. So that's my y. Okay. And so that's what I have. Now, how is this going to work in then, right? I'm ultimately hoping to have some sort of model where I can say something like this. X dot coefficients is going to give me this y. And so really what I wish I could do is something like this. I wish I could say something like c equals y divided by x, but you cannot do that. And the reason why is that when I do this division like this, that's an element-wise division. And so that would be kind of the appropriate opposite of an element-wise multiplication. The dot product is not an element-wise multiplication, right? So this kind of division wouldn't work. And actually, in general, right, there's not something exactly the same as division for that's kind of the opposite of the dot product multiplication, right? So I can't do that. I do know it's solvable, right? Because I can solve the equivalent problem manually of kind of subtracting one equation off of the other. And so the good news is that NumPy can solve for c given x and y. And the way I do that is I say numpy.linear algebra. And so that's like a submodule, and there's a bunch of stuff in it, right? If I just take a peek at dir, lots of different things I could do. And one of the things I could do is I could do a solve, right? So I may say NumPy, that linear algebra, that solve. And I see, well, what do I have here? And I see they have A and B. And that's kind of like what the math people, those are the variables the math people usually use instead of X and Y, right? So when I'm doing this, instead of having my A and B, I'm just trying to say I want to have my X, my Y, and I solve that. And so what am I having here, right? So I have a bunch of numbers, and it turns out it's a little hard to see right now, but these are actually the numbers we had for our model last time. Maybe we can see it easier if I flatten it, right? So, I could do this, right? Maybe put C here, right? And then peek at it. You know, let me just test these numbers before I actually try to pull them out and look at them. If I have this X, right, this is all my data, and I pull out the first row, right? So this is kind of what I was doing last time. Here's the first row, and I take the dot product of that with the C that I just created, I get to 196, right? So I'm kind of going back and forth, right? I went from knowing my X and my Y to figuring out these coefficients. And now I can go backwards. I can then use my X and my coefficients to reproduce the Y. And the beauty of that then is I could also have new X values as well and make predictions for new Y values that I haven't seen before. Right, so I can do that. And also, right, remember I could do this last time, right? Instead of going horizontal vector by vertical vector, I could just say X dot product C, and I could make all my predictions at once. Okay, so I said I wanted to look a little bit closer at C, and maybe what I'll do is I'll just flatten it. I'll say reshape and one dimensional, just like that, and then I could actually convert this thing to a list. I could see, well, here were the coefficients we had last time. It was, you know, 42.3, 10, 1.67, and then negative 3, 2, 1, 3. And one of the skills you should have is if you do this kind of operation, you solve for your coefficients, you should be able to talk about your coefficients meaningfully. So for example, this was on the zeroth column, and this is on the first column. And so what were those? These were beds and baths. All right, so here I have beds and here I have baths. And I should be able to make decisions based on that. For example, if I'm trying to, you know, flip a house and I want to install either a new bedroom or a new bathroom, I can see, well, installing a new bedroom would increase the value a lot more than a new bathroom in this case, kind of for this simple data set. So you should be able to talk about coefficients and the implications they have for decision making.